Should autism and Asperger's be considered separate disorders? The debate in the medical community rages on. Hey guys, this is Annie, guest hosting for DNews. This week, the Scottish singer Susan Boyle made headlines by announcing her diagnosis of Asperger Syndrome, opening up new conversations about the often misunderstood condition. Asperger's is characterized by difficulty in social interaction and nonverbal communication, and in some cases, clumsiness, atypical use of language, and other symptoms. And currently, it's considered part of Autism Spectrum Disorder, a diagnosis that's increased significantly over the past two decades. According to the British Medical Journal, autism diagnoses were rare in the UK and the US until the 90s, when the rates began surging. They've since leveled off in the UK, but according to the Center for Disease Control, autism rates have continued to grow in the US. As of 2008, 1 in 88 children were identified as being on the autism spectrum. The spectrum contains a range of conditions characterized by social and communicative challenges and certain behavioral patterns. ASD is about 5 times as prevalent in boys as in girls. The spike in rates is not fully understood, though it's been suggested that the spike is related to increased awareness and changing diagnostic standards. What the autism spectrum entails is still being hammered out in the medical community. Earlier this year, for example, Asperger syndrome was removed from the DSM-5, which is the manual that psychiatrists use to diagnose. It was folded in with autism as basically a higher functioning form of the disorder. Asperger's patients don't typically suffer from cognitive or linguistic impairment and are often above average intelligence. Still, newer research finds that there may in fact be significant biological differences between Asperger's and autism. Harvard neurologists and psychiatrists measured brain connectivity among Asperger's and autism patients using a measure called EEG coherence. They found that this measure could be a distinguishing factor, but that larger studies are needed, also pointing out that those differences can have huge implications for patients, their families, and their caregivers. As always, let us know your thoughts in the comments. For DNews, this is Annie.